waste my time. I used to get no replies, now all the girls wanna hold this pipe. Me and bro done hella footwork, now we got a booming line.
What's going on, my people? It's your boy Dan, Ossie here, and
boy Kaz.
Follow me on Twitter, Ossie or Dan.
Follow me on Twitter, Kaz Idris.
Hey, listen, you look, come here, come closer. Welcome to a new segment on the channel called Hot Topic.
That's
you get me? Where we talk about topics that are hot.
Hot topics, man. That's it.
We give our opinions.
Yeah.
You let us know your opinions as well.
Yeah. Long story short.
Short story long.
We're going to make a separate segment aside from the reactions where we just speak on stuff like this. For example, the 6ix9ine INSTA live.
If you don't got this watch right here, you a little boy to me. I'll kiss you on your forehead. You a little boy.
You look like that. There was a lot of interaction in the comments. So this is a similar type of thing.
In this particular hot topic, we're gonna be talking about the 6ix9ine situation, what's going on with him, how he's doing his things.
6ix9ine as a topic at the moment, bro. It's a really hot topic.
Literally.
And, like, now he's come with another Insta live and another track. I know he's got two albums on the way.
He's got two albums on the way. See, I didn't know that.
And one is gonna be in English and one is gonna be in Spanish. So it's gonna be really interesting because everyone's he says I'm the hottest rapper right now, but he's doing the most numbers.
He can't really deny it.
Like,
he is doing
it. It's one of those things, like, you just can't.
Talking of numbers though, later on in the video I wanna bring something to your attention, man.
So since he's come out, all that's been spoken about is his name.
It's literally his name.
A high topic. And the thing is, we've got so many other things to worry about at the moment. But he's been such a relevant topic.
Really hot
and
topic.
And it's kind of hard to turn a blind eye to it, if you're going to be honest.
You know what I'm saying?
It's hard to turn a blind eye to it.
It's ridiculous, bro. Like, since he's come out, what? He's jumped on Instagram Live, broke that record. Mm-hmm. But then I know that recently someone has broken that record again. Mm.
Again?
Yeah, no, yeah. Someone broke it after him. Yeah, after him.
Who?
There was a group of... I'll try to find a video. If I can find a video, I'll input it.
It is what it is.
Bro, they literally came together as a group of them to break 6ix9ine's record and they were cheering.
That was their plan, bro. Oh,
and
my
they broke
God.
It. They actually broke it, so they spat on it. I think they got 3 million views.
I can't lie to you, that shit, he's got a lot of haters.
Yeah, he's got a lot of haters. Actually came out
that's
to break
insane.
His record.
Yeah,
so that just goes to show what kind of weight his name holds.
Yeah, but it's just a crazy fact that like their only objective, like his objective for example is to make music.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Their sole objective,
was to break
6ix9ine's record. He's obviously pissed off a lot of people.
Yeah, a lot of people, bro.
And let's not forget the YouTube record that he broke.
Yeah, he pissed on that.
Eminem. So Eminem had the most views in, I think it was 24 hours.
Yeah.
And he came and he just ruined that.
He ruined that
in the first day since he dropped his music. His marketing works, let's just say that.
Yeah, man.
The way he's doing his thing, it does work.
It works still. What was it? Last week, I think, I see that he posted something on his Instagram saying that the Billboards were lying on him.
Oh.
They were doing the koalas on his thing. They were doing the koalas on his thing, and it was looking a bit iffy, fam. And it was bringing up stating facts.
Yeah,
like,
it was looking a bit suspicious, man, and fluorescent. Yeah.
Suspicious men in fluorescent jackets.
It was looking a bit like that. He mentioned that, bro, these lot are using like several different credit cards
to get this. Credit cards to order like 30,000 copies or something of like Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber singing.
Yeah.
Just in the last minutes so that they could overtake him.
You can buy number ones on Billboard. I want that to register in your head. They bought 30,000 and so units with six credit cards.
This is something that the general public won't know, and he's trying to give you that inside information, and he's saying, look, this is exactly what happened, they're rooting against me.
Yeah,
but the industry is a complicated place.
You know, listen to this though. If it's happening to him like that, how many other artists that really and truly should have been there?
Yeah. The thing is, but that's what I'm saying, the industry is a complicated place, because even today he was saying like there's something called blackballing someone from the industry. So it's like you kind of shy them away from like radio plays and
all this kind of stuff where they would get extra streams
and stuff like that. You shy them away from that and you kind of just toss
put them under the table.
Yeah.
You get me? Just
and
sweep them
with
under
normal
the table.
Rappers, it has a strong effect. Like you can actually see they were relevant. Now they're not relevant.
All of a sudden
they're just not relevant. But with someone that's making this much noise, how do you stop it?
There is no way of stopping it. You get me? There is actually no way of stopping it, fam. I think the only way you can stop it is if you start to involve Meek Mill And Snoop Dogg is signed.
But he involved them. No one's involved. He's involved them.
He involved them. So like, what? We just watched the Instagram live, yeah?
And you can like blatantly see he's disrespecting.
Bro, disrespecting.
Meek, you're a fucking rat.
Disrespected Meek Mill. He disrespected Snoop Dogg. In a sense, he even disrespected Jay-Z's company.
Rock Nation. No, he's saying
their executive is the one that's been done for this. Seeing her, yeah. I'd never think
that she is.
That's what she's capable of.
Bro, wires.
That.
Kilos of coke.
Kilos?
KG. Kilos? Bro. Man, them like, pushed that in gym, bro. She's moving that.
Like, that really took me by surprise.
So what, he outed Meek Mill for messing with that lady.
He done Snoop Dogg. Apparently Snoop Dogg's paperwork's all over the internet. And what's his name? Suge Knight. So Suge Knight as well, there's a video of him. But he's posted that video before using an Insta Live. That's where I'd seen it before. Mm-hmm. Basically saying that, yo, like, Snoop Dogg's cooperating because how's he not inside type of thing. Like,
I've got a question for you lot though, man. I've got a real life question for you lot. See how 6ix9ine is saying, how everyone's saying, yo, 6ix9ine's a rat, you can't mess with him no more, we don't mess with rats. 6ix9ine's saying that, rah, like, bro, Meek Mill, gee, your executive.
You're messing with rats.
It's a rat.
Long story short, you're messing with rats.
Yeah, so
but everyone said you can't mess with me, because the only thing wrong with him right now is that he's a rat.
And if you mess with a rat, you're a rat. So what do you lot think? You lot think, click up there and let me know. Do you lot think he's a rat for doing that? How is it working?
It doesn't make sense, because he's gone and taken this situation and put it on someone else and said, but look, but how about this person?
Yeah, how about that?
How about that? When you start digging and finding information, you can really ruin a person's credibility.
As we found out on Twitter.
Yeah, and have you seen the recent thing about Gunna?
No.
Gunna, basically, there's an interview of him on, I'll find the video. It's a situation where his cousin must have gone inside for something he didn't do. And on CNN, I believe it was, there's like an interview of him talking to the feds, but this is before he was Gunna.
Everybody looking at it like it was wrong because this man would let my family member, you know what I'm saying, go down for something he did. Right. They actually had on the same exact color. Okay. He just had on the hood, and Devo didn't. He had on a regular shirt.
He said, look, like, my cousin didn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
But 6ix9ine is saying that technically he's snitching. Saying that, look, he's cooperating with them to say that his cousin is not the right person. But Gunner's side is basically saying, look,
but
if it's my cousin and he didn't do it, I'm only saying that he didn't do it.
Yeah,
Gunner didn't say that person.
Okay,
did it.
Yeah, that I would have.
He didn't say that person did it.
I
he said it's not my cousin who's the person who done it.
Nah, I wouldn't
like,
that.
It's not a direct thing, but he's putting it out there saying, look, like, even Gunner's cooperating. He's doing interviews with this and that.
He's trying to remix it.
Everyone. Yeah,
he's really trying to remix that.
He's trying to remix it. Still.
Get me on remix though.
Yeah, speaking of remixes. Come I mean,
on. I'm locked up, it won't let me out, oh, it won't let me out. Bro, how he's landed that is ridiculous, fam.
Got me tweaking, fighting with my lawyers for a better offer. Just wanna see my daughter, cause I'm locked up, it won't let me
out. You know what I find weird with it, yeah?
Mm.
Akon is not someone to chase clout.
Yeah, he's really not.
So how has that come about? Because Akon must, like, I don't believe he's gone for it. For the clout.
Nah.
I believe there's something else that he's seeing. Like, I firmly believe there's something else he's seeing. Because if it was a clout thing, number one, why have you waited this long? There's been hot rappers before this.
Way could have
just given it to them to, like,
number
given them
two,
the sample.
This guy, you know, 6ix9ine, is not someone that you want to be known to be messing with.
To be affiliated with, yeah.
Yeah, but then, you know what I see as? Definitely a money move. You see what he's trying to do with everything in Africa.
Yeah,
I feel like
but
this
at
is
the same
just...
time, at the same time, you could say money move, yeah, but like, a money move, I would say personally, is if he just gave him the sample and he just kind of like stood back. He's in videos affiliating himself with him.
Mm.
Like, if it was a money move, you would have been like, take, cool, give me the piece, and I'm out. You get, like, you would have been out of the situation. Yeah. You're gonna be on videos and stuff promoting his thing.
Yeah, that's a techie one.
So,
still.
Like, maybe the message, maybe he messes with 6ix9ine's message in the song. I don't understand. I don't know what he's looking at. But I'm not sure if it's a money move or not. What do you not think?
I was gonna, earlier in the video, I said something about his views breaking a record and that on YouTube and that. Nah, I was on Instagram right the other day. You know Adam 22, the one that he hosts No Jumper?
Yeah, No Jumper.
Right, cool. So he must have tweeted 6ix9ine thing, quote tweeted it, saying something like, bro, these views are not matching the streams, bro. What, 16 million, 17 million, 22 million views on what, on YouTube?
Oh, on you, okay, okay.
But then on Spotify, got 2 million. So what's going on there? Yeah. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Who's really lying about the numbers?
Yeah, because now, that's the same narrative he had against Billboard, yeah, saying that they weren't lying about the numbers.
You are buying your different views and stuff like
but
that.
Now he's saying, this many views on YouTube, this many views on Spotify. I think it could be a thing where, because the track actually, well, to me anyway, it didn't entice me that much. It wasn't,
yeah, it
that
wasn't
good
actually
of a track.
A song.
Like, it wasn't a song that I'd go to search in my own time.
Never.
I think that's why if someone would have watched it on YouTube when it dropped,
they would
not
go back
and search it on Spotify.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it's not on my Spotify, I'll tell you that.
So, bro, I don't think I'm
as you've seen our reaction to it, we did listen to it on the YouTube, but it's not on my Spotify. I think quality of song has an influence on that as well.
Yeah, true, true. But then again,
but the numbers are still,
yeah, that's
quite,
bro,
distant,
bro.
Yeah.
20
yeah,
million
yeah,
difference.
Yeah,
come
that's,
on,
that's still,
come
that's
on,
still
that's
a big
bit
difference. Yeah.
Iffy.
Yes, so we've reached the end of our first episode of Hot Topics.
Sir!
So, if you don't want to see more, and if you don't have any topics in mind that you would want us to speak on, I want to see it in the comments. I want to see you guys speaking about it. I want to see the interaction as well in the comments going on.
Yeah.
We're going to read all the comments.
Yes, sir, no get.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, get.
Yes, sir, ski, double O, ski, bro, ski.
Yeah.
Hey, what though, man? If you don't enjoy the video, make sure you
a
like.
Leave a comment.
A share and
subscribe.
Because we're...
Euphoria. I ain't never felt like this before. Euphoria. You give me a little man, I want some more.